So John, the squad building continues with two new arrivals today. Firstly, looking at the defensive side, you've tied up Regan Tumulty. Tell us a bit about him. How did you first spot him, and what's he going to bring to the squad overall?
Yeah, well, I've mentioned it recently that we're after right back, and Regan impressed me when he played for Dumbarton, particularly the game here. I don't think he played in the games at Dumbarton. He played in the game here. He was on loan to Dumbarton from Morton, and I thought he did really well in the game out here. Unfortunately, that was a game that we lost. So, but he did. I thought he did well, and I followed his going when he went back to Morton after January. Coincided with Morton actually doing very well in the second half of the season, and I continued to watch him on video through the Y Scout stuff. So he's exactly what we're looking for. I think he's now gained a lot of experience. He's a natural right back, that is his position, you know. So I think that's going to give us a really, really good balance. You know, Kieran McDonald did an amazing job for us last season. And if Regan can do a similar type of job down the right-hand side, then that will give us a lot of firepower. You know, obviously we need to defend well. Also, he's quick, very quick. He's determined. He's a fit boy. You know, he ticks all the boxes. It gives us a back four that's going to be like 6 foot right across the whole of the back four. Maybe give him play with. Three centre backs, we could play with two wing backs, we can change it as we have done last season, and we will probably continue to do. For me, it's a good signing. We're after him for some time. It's actually been agreed for a good wee while, actually. It's been agreed for a wee while, but I wanted to make sure when I say to somebody, I'm bringing you here to play in the Championship, I wanted to make sure that we were in the Championship. I didn't want someone to be coming under false pretence. So we had to wait until after the arbitration and the tribunal, and then unfortunately Regan was away on holiday, so it's taken this bit longer to actually announce this. Mm. Albeit that it was all kind of done and dusted for a few weeks now. Yeah. So delighted to get it done. I think he'll be a big asset to us. I think we're getting him at a great age where he can still go and kick on, and if I was him, I'd be ambitious and want to play in the top league, and I think we can give them the platform to do that.
Mm. And at the other end of the pitch, if you like, we've also got the striker coming in, Manny Duku, who's coming up to us from down south. He's not a name that many folk in Kirkcaldy will be aware of, and so in a similar sort of vein, how did you become aware of him, and what's he going to bring to your squad?
Yeah. Well, I was actually aware of him this time last year, probably earlier, and that's probably around about May, June of last season. You know, you get more and more contacts with different agents, a lot more agents down south are trying to bring in the players up here. You can see that Kilmarnock signed a couple of guys for the non-league. Hamilton just signed a striker for the non-league. You know, there's more and more having to come up here because, you know, there's not so many strikers, and when you look at Manny's 6 feet three. Mm. You know, there's not many strikers in Scotland that size. So we're not a long ball team, and we're not one who's just going to knock it up there. But there are times where you need that physicality, you need that strength, you need that power, and he's quick. You know, and he'll cause defences problems. So I first came across him last year, didn't think we would have got him last year. But this year, I tried a little bit harder and we managed to get him up here. So he's the type of boy that if he's on fire, he's going to be a real handful for defenders. He'll cause a lot of problems for them, and he'll give us something that we don't have, that big physique player up there. And to be his size and to be quick, you know, it's a great combination. So although, no, he's not a household name, but as I say, you'll probably find that the players that are coming up from England, you know, probably no one's heard of the lad that signed for Hamilton, and probably the guy that signed for Kilmarnock, and you know, there's a lot more of this kind of happening. I mean, Motherwell are very good at picking up these type of guys from the lower leagues in England, and then all of a sudden they're playing in the Premiership and they're playing regularly, and all of a sudden you're saying, what a great find. So again, at 27, he's a good age. He's a very, very good age for us. He's now gained a lot of experience. He is Dutch, but he's been playing in the lower leagues in England and the non-league scene since 2015. And, you know, when he's hot, he's really hot.
Good. Well, he's one of these players that, you know, to us he's an unknown quantity, and we're looking forward to seeing him in action. Looking at the overall squad, you know, you said in the local press this week that you're still after a winger, a striker and a defender. It's nice to see the squad coming together, but for you as a manager, you know, things come up, you know, Dave McKay's injury and other scenarios are going to happen. Off camera you were saying that over the course of last season, we didn't have many players that didn't get injured. I mean, just talk to us about the challenge of being a manager and building a squad.
You know, I think the players and everyone should take a lot of credit for what we managed to do last season with so many players out, you know. And unfortunately, we start from that position again right now with not being able to, you know, put out a full strength squad for the entire season. Yeah, I looked at, you know, the other day there with regards to Ian Davison missed 6 games through suspension, never injured. Kev Benedictus missed 1 or 2 games through suspension, never injured. Kieran McDonald was never injured. John Baird was never injured. Stephen McLean had a short period where, but wasn't injured. After that, every other player was injured, and some for considerable time. So, again, it stands in good stead and everything that the players did to actually continue to win the league, you know. So, you know, we didn't seem to get much luck on the injury scene. So, although we're starting with Dave, it is an injury for last season. So hopefully we don't get, you know, a season like we did, you know, last season, the amount of injuries that we had, we could do without that. But yeah, it makes it tricky, it makes the job tricky. And, you know, I mentioned there in that other interview with regards to that Dumbarton game. I mean, you know, to have the squad that we had in the stand that day, it was 8 players out, you know, an unrecognisable, like, defence, it becomes really, really difficult. But that's unfortunately, you've got to deal with that. You've got to try and get the best out of what we had, and you know, I think we did that.
Yeah. Well, and as you just said there, that's the challenge of being a manager in modern game. Thanks for that, John. We look forward to more additions as and when they happen, and then after that, I suppose it's players back into training.
Yeah, we're due back on the 17th of August, and that will give us plenty of time. What we mentioned previously about we needed a right back, we needed a striker, so we've got a striker in, we've got a right back in. Yeah, we're obviously looking for another striker with the Dave McKay situation. We're looking for a centre back now. But we've now got, I mean, we could say we've got 19 players now, 20 players, 20 players, you know, so. You know, we've got a squad there that we could go and play a game tomorrow, and we could be a little bit imaginative with 1 or 2 positions with players. But you know, still look to get a striker, and a winger, and a centre back in. But we've got plenty of time, and there's, you know, okay, 1 or 2 players are going, but there's more and more players surfacing and coming to the fore at the same time.
Great, thanks for that, John, and good luck.
Right, thanks, Neil.
Ta.